हेलो
Yes, sir. Let the session be recorded first. I'll tell you when to start, sir.
ओके सर, योर नेम प्लीज।
My name is Majid Nisar.
ओके
Good afternoon, all. I welcome you to the second session of the day. We have the immense pleasure of having Dr. Seva Nayak D with us. Sir is a senior scientist of plant physiology, seed technology division, IICAR, IGFRI, Jhansi, UP. And the topic chosen by sir for deliverance, physiological tools and techniques for screening abiotic stresses in forage and crop plants for
सेवा
sustainable agriculture production. Sir, your audible as well as
उसको
your presentation is visible. Please start.
हेलो, कैन आई स्टार्ट
All other participants are requested to keep their microphones on mute or will be removed. Please, I have removed someone who is not keeping their audio on mute. Please keep your audios on mute so that we could listen to the lecture. Sir, please start.
Thank you, sir, for inviting me. I am Dr. Seva Nayak, plant physiologist, and today I am going to present on topic physiological tools and techniques for screening abiotic traces in forage and crop plants for sustainable agriculture production. Outline of presentation, introduction, abiotic traces, difficulties in abiotic trace breeding, importance of abiotic trace breeding, facility, tools, techniques required for abiotic traces, minimum data set of abiotic trace experiment, progress of abiotic trace breeding, and conclusion. Introduction for drought, flood, and high temperature, cold, salinity, nutrients availability, heavy metals are abiotic trace factor that have a significant effect on world agriculture, account for more than 50% reduction in average potential yield of most of major food and fodder crops. These comprise mostly high temperature 40%, salinity 20%, drought 17%, low temperature 15%, and other form of traces. The human population is increasing and expected to grow from 6.9 million to 6.9 million to 9 million by 2050. To feed the increasing population, we need to improve the food production by 60% up to 2050 with limited land and water resources. The demand for food livestock production will be continue to rise with increasing global population, therefore improving production and productivity to ensure the sustainable yield under changing environmental condition is essential. To achieve this predictor goal, food security, we need to increase our understanding of plant response to abiotic traces. Knowledge of natural selection, trace breeding, genetic manipulation of plant that can be maintained a higher photosynthetic rate, better foliage growth, and improve the yield under test condition. Elements of enhanced breeding strategy, wider hybridization, marker assisted breeding, transgenic. Genetic resource stress tolerant integration of line and gene bank assertion, genomic identifying candidate gene, conferring the yield under test condition, crop improvement, and the free breeding lines, these are the near isogenic lines and recombinant. We can, these are the elements, and we can, and I am targeting on genetic resource and stress tolerant integration of line and gene bank assertion. What are the traces? temperature, cold, drought, flood, salinity, shade, and heavy metal touch. And avoidance, ability of plant to complete its life cycle before the serious soil and plant water deficit occur. Tolerance, water potential, it will be maintained. To then only high water potential, low water potential, it should be maintained. Resistant, what are the more due to physiological condition of plant like stomatal aperture, photosynthetic rate, and root artery structures. This is the simple figure. For heat stress and salinity, membrane damage and nutrient imbalance, and high transpiration rate, water deficiency, and elevated evaporation. Then cold stress, the decrease the rate of biochemical reaction, crystal mediated damage, and free radical damage. Then heavy metal, then drought and heavy metal decrease the photosynthesis, water transport inhibition, and bioaccumulation and protein damage. So this is the simple picture for drought. Escape, it means completion of life cycle before the stress occurs. Then dehydration, drought avoidance means then increasing the ABA and stomatal closure, a drastic crop photosynthetic rate, and enhance the root growth. If drought avoidance increasing the root growth, stomatal closure, then evapotranspiration loss is less. So it is the avoidance mechanism. This is the completion of before completion is the escape mechanism. And drought tolerant mechanism, metabolically adjustment, accumulation of osmolytes, accumulation of protective proteins, ROS detoxification, reactive oxygen species by detoxification by antioxidant. And cell wall hardening. By this is the simple picture, we can understand the mechanism and different mechanism of how to tolerate, how to avoid it, and how to escape the mechanism in plants. Difficulties in abiotic stress breeding. Screening techniques require high skill and they are time consuming. Creation of artificial condition is expensive. Under field screening, nature may or may not provide a optimum condition for killing. In many cases, in vitro technique are followed by which is expensive. Abiotic stress breeding depend mostly on physiological traits which are often not stable. Why physiological approach is the need? Increasing genetic variability is an important trait for faster growth in yield. If physiological type has been higher heritability than wheat, the more cost effective than yield evaluation, after season selection, more generation per year, more enumerable marker assistant selection lead to pyramiding and multiple yield enhancing traits. This is the simple hypothesis figure. Hypothesis desirability. What is the desirable trait? We have to choose the first point. Develop the effective screening procedure. Reputation, heritable, cost effective, and crossing. Control environment and field condition. Establish screen, confirm the damage in the field. Screening diverse group of germplasm. Current and old germplasm cultivar, germplasm from target environment, which target environment we are targeting, and which stress we are the need to target. Land risk mapping, identify the best donor. If we find the best donor, then can we go for back cross breeding, field evaluation, contrasting line, and commercial cultivation. Identify and develop the mapping population to determine the genetic control and identify the molecular marker, and you can go for the molecular study. What are the facility need for physiological work? Generally for drought and salinity, rainout center, hydroponics, growth chambers. For temperature problem, C and CO2, OTC, open top chamber, and TGT, temperature gradient tenants. The instrument and tools, I am here mentioned the all the instrument and most almost are spectrophotometer, SPAD meter, leap year year meet a infrared gas inlet girga CTD canopy temperature depression isotope ratio mass spectrography osmometer vapor pressure meter electrical conductivity meter flame photometer atomic absorption spectrophotometer lights microscope pH meter generation Gobel and centrifuge hot work with stereo microscope HPLC GC high performance liquid chromatography and chromatography soil moisture meters because these are the instrument we compulsory new for physiological work for abiotic traces because for all the traces not only one trace some instrument need some other parameter and some traces but I listed for all the traces here facility and techniques and methodology and tools and instrument needed techniques hydroponic trench technique drought salinity heavy metal pressure hydroponics when I was joined here hydroponics in hydroponics we can conduct also the drought trace because that time I am not knowing the hydroponics in we can conduct the drought trace in that way in polyethylene glycol this is the chemical in hydroponics is generally used for root study and metabolic element metal heavy metal trace and for green fodder for maintain but in hydroponics we can study by abiotic trace drought salinity heavy metal also because hydroponics you know it is a silent culture then here we are using Hoagland solution in Hoagland solution we can add the PG PEG polyethylene glycol it is a drought you can conduct the by the hydroponics in the drought test in salinity in that you having a hydrocoating Hoagland solution we add the salts different salt and then we can create so we can study the hydroponic by hydroponic simple and then we can study the drought and salinity also here also I mentioned in the petri dish drought salinity heavy metal as you know everything everyone and test to mother drought salinity heavy metal germination paper polythene bag drought salinity temperature traces tools what are the tools we need here tools spectrophotometer is needed spad meter soil plant analysis development chlorophyll meter by this meter we can large germ plasm you can screen because manually or by spectrophotometer total chlorophyll or chlorophyll A B you can't estimate a large number of samples so spad meter it is not accurate and good but you can use this meter and you can estimate the chlorophyll it is total chlorophyll and a large number of samples we can screen by spad spectrometer leaf area meter leaf shape of the any shape of the leaf area you can measure because length width we can manually we can do it but without leaf area meter you can't estimate the large number of samples and many type of the shape of the leaf also we can measure in the leaf irga infrared gas analyzer photosynthetic parameters we can canopy temperature difference is the difference between the temperature and plant canopy isotope ratio mass spectrography carbon isotope discriminate technique osmometer is osmotic liquid the plant osmotic condition you can estimate EC meter electrical conductivity EC meter we need for a salinity trace flame photometer for estimating sodium and potassium atomic absorption spectrophotometry nutrient analysis a light microscope it is the used for root parenchyma methodologies are RWC MSI photosynthetic pigment 80% acetone and DMSO method but acetone method is very easy for large number of population or germplasm screening DMSO is a method it is difficult and large number of samples and estimation is difficult because of the acetone is the easy method for screening exploration rapid screening techniques first of all you have to know and select the diverse group of germplasm. So first need to collect the germplasm. So exploration, maximum capture the maximum amount of variation in smallest number of sample allelic reaches for given locus. So handling and maintenance of preliminary and rapid screening, handling and maintaining condition experiment and screening for large population is difficult. So maximum population of germplasm should be discarded at the ground level. Mean we can't detail study and basic study, we can't study and all the parameters, but if we are taking the large germplasm, we have to discard. So if first preliminary screening maximum germplasm should discard at a preliminary stage from large size population germplasm resource for genetic and maximum amount of variation genetic makeup in smallest number of samples. Critical level of stress, we have to find out the critical level, then only we sort out the, if it suppose 100,000 of germplasm or number of samples, we can sort out and you come out in a 15 or 20, then only basic study and basic parameters you can take. Otherwise, if we are conducting all, then it is not possible. So first critical level and find out critical level and give the only one trace and then sort out the germplasm and come down the larger population to lesser population. And then develop the rapid screening technique methodology protocol. Find out the rapid screening technique methodology protocol for screening and preliminary screening. General points, passport data, if you are conducting the experiment, we need to know that passport data. Suppose we have 100 or 1000 of germplasm is there. From that, we can choose from which germplasm or which accession collection from there. From there, if we are knowing that suppose the Kashmir from collected from Kashmir and then the Dharwada condition. So then generally that Kashmir germplasm is a cold tolerant, we can discard from there. Or nearby suppose Dharwada and Hubli. So Dharwad near collection, if it is there, so same character, same it is there, don't then discard that nearby allocation of the germplasm. So by collecting that passport data, we can discard some germplasm because it is 1000, 3000, 4000, 100,000 of germplasm is giving, it is not possible. So then discard by the knowing that passport data. Grouping germplasm and morphology, phenology, phenotypic or genotypic and seed vigor induction, flowering and maturity state. Grouping, before the starting the experiment, we should know if we suppose there 200 germplasm is there, and we should first 1 or 2 years we group, because one it is the long duration, one germplasm is the short duration. And we are giving the address and maintaining the some certain period of them. And the long duration it will be extend, and short duration it is generally it is escaping the trace. But generally the people are doing that is the long duration, so that short duration is discarding, it means long duration is the target. It is not a good procedure of following the method. So first of all we group it, and grouping, and then you can go for the experiment. The same grouping should be taken. Take the diverse genetic group of germplasm for experiment. Take that, already I explained that, take the diverse genetic group of germplasm. Multiply the germplasm and substance sheet material for experiment. Collect the weather data, meteorological department, and find out where the target environment, and know the target right for crop improvement. For collecting weather data, meteorological data, we can found and we can target that at a particular trait. So you can use as a under passport data. I use the check line and genotype variety for trait comparison, varietal development. Check line or genotype variety, but because you are already known, if you are knowing that a particular variety or particular line is a tolerating. So for lab Durham plaza, you can check as a check, you can for tolerant check. If you are not knowing, then you first of all, initially you have to screen in the all the Durham plaza. If it is there, then you can age or otherwise some other crops tolerant or related species we can use as a check if it is not available in the same crop. Experimental design, augmented design, paper germination method, in vitro test tube method for easy for rapid and simple preliminary screening. These are the simple and the easy method for large number of population or germ samples because CRD, RBD, in field condition in the RBD is in the replication level. And large number of population we can't conduct because it's very time consuming and take the space. Type of design already explained. The minimum number of plant samples should be taken from segregation population is 30 to 35 plant from augmented region. Because here we are not following the same RBD, so augmented region from more number of plants. Germplasm or sample we can take at least 5 to 6 back crosses or more for getting the stable for the stable heritable character. So before the starting the minimum data setup for ABIT traces for suppose we here drought experiment, agronomic condition for crop culture, soil type, structure, physical property, pH, soil EC, nutrient application, spacing, soil moisture data, a different depth at least 2 points before triple root zone, at least 2 times points on each for start and end of the drought test, quantity and interval of the irrigation, when how much we are giving and interval when we are giving, so different also we have to minimum data set up, crop growth changes, whose stage we are going to import, duration of the trace, how much duration, plant water status, what is the plant water status, phenology, yield and yield component, weather, rainfall data, temperature, national regional check genotype as a control unit. Here I am classified and giving the first for simple for understanding. Because sometimes trace imposing and dating and doing and screening, but we are not knowing that what much and which trace level we are given. So severe drought is available soil moisture between 40 to 50% or soil moisture depletion between 50 to 60% during the plant growth period. It is comes under a water deficit. The moderate water deficit, available soil moisture between 50 to 60% or soil depletion moisture between 40 to 60% during the plant growth period. This is moderate. The mild water deficit, available moisture is between 60 to 70% or soil moisture depletion 30 to 40% during the plant growth period. No deficit or full irrigation, this is the available soil moisture between 70 to 80% or soil moisture depletion 32 during the plant growth, because here symptoms very less and we can't see the test. Above irrigation amount of irrigated may or more than plant required. So this is the soil parameters, but as a plant physiologist we have to know in the soil also and in plant also, in plant itself and soil, and we are so concentrate on plant. When a relative water leaf, relative water content in leaf, normal value of RWC range between 98% in fully target transferring leaf to about 30 to 40 in severe desiccated and drying leaves, depend upon the plant facing. Most species, the typical leaf RWC is around, initial wilting is around 60 to 70% is exception, because here the wilting, it means if it supports 60 to 70% adaptation. The crop growth stage, at which stage we have to impose, at 3 stages: seedling, vegetative and reproductive or fibrin. But practicing condition and we are proper screening taking, we take the most probably at the vegetative stage is better. Seedling stage is very less, and can't tell that by seedling it is tolerant. And yet the reproductive and mature premature stage, it is almost all senescent stage. So senescent stage we can't go there and conduct, but vegetative stage is the most. If you are having time and you are having sufficient facility, you can go the for the three stages: seedling, vegetative, and reproductive mature stage. Duration of the stress, at least we have to impose the stress 7 to 15 days at seedling, 15 to 20 to 30% at vegetative, or 15 to 20 at vegetative, premature or reproductive stage. Because here we are giving less stress at premature, because it is almost all going senescent, so we are here reduction. But in case of grasses, range and tropical grasses, we can extend the days 30 to 45 days for vegetative and reproductive crop, and crop to crop is always variation in them. So for that is already explained for drought. For salinity, problematic soils and salinity, the soil samples should be collected from different soil layer in different depth based on the plant species, preferably in the root zone. The root depth samples layer at least 0 to 5, 10 to 20, 40 to 60 centimeters, so on at least 1 meter depth. The sample should be different layers should be mixed thoroughly. Here we target on the our crop and what is the root length we first of all know, and then go the and soil sampling what depth we should be take the soil. This is a simple table, and because I am not going to detail here, but we know that where is the normal soil, what is the range, normal soil, saline soil, sodic soil, and saline sodic soil. By this table, soil scientists, they know very well, but in other scientists, where we are going to conduct, and what is the range it is there, and how to, and where to conduct, then regarding by this table, if it is pH this much, and that the saline, we are going to saline soil, this is more than soil ECE, then you see, then only it is saline soil. So if we are artificially and are transported soil, collecting soil, we should know the, and this is minimum or basic parameter we should know. Then only we can understand the we are conducting sodic soil or saline soil. Sometime it is just salt rich. Salt rich, it is comes under all sodic soil, saline soil, or sodic saline soil, but not particular. So by we know by this table, and then crop respond to salinity, measure the electrical conductivity of soil, saturated, extracted. Soil depth, non-soil or salt-free, weakly saline or saline. Moderately saline, strongly saline, very strongly saline. In broccoli, it is the soil water concentration. And sometimes we are conducting the experiment, we have saline soil and normal irrigation. And then it is also soil problematic soil. If it is a soil is normal and water is a saline. So which range or which is the comes under saline soil or moderately or strongly or heavy strongly, we know that by the this table we can understand. For understanding only I am projecting here. Crop responses, then salinity is affect mostly negligible exception in heavy sensitive plant. Here this is the rate, then less than 4 ECE. Then yield very sensitive crop grass is a 48, and where will most of crop restricted 8 to 16%. Only tolerant crops can satisfy here is 15 to 20, and only few crops are crop yield are satisfied. By this table, we can know where is the soil, we see which crop. First of all, we know that the crop and where we can plant. This is just simple figure also. We can by the table and by this figure also can see that soil is, it is sensitive from and moderately from to this range and moderately tolerant this range, tolerant and unstable. If it is beyond that soil is, it is unstable. So by simple figure also you can understand for conducting in the soil experiment. This is I calculated some salt and and given here a table. Required salt required gram per liter for different EC's for creating. This is the calculation part for 4, 12, 8, 12 and 16, up to 16 EC I calculated. This is the calculation part. But this is in gram per liter, how much we need. So for germination study, we need or for giving the irrigation water, salt water, then we are which soil is we are maintaining the irrigation water or for germination pot by this way, you can follow this table. And also for saturating soil and soil is artificial making soil. Also, you can use this saline water, and after saline getting again, we have to measure the soil, and you can identify the and you can tell that this is the soil, how much soil is generated, and if it is generally by following this method, this is the solution for soil water. If you are creating artificial soil from generally, if you are suppose. Prepare this much salt are given and kg of soil, it may less, so generally it goes to down as per our estimation. So again that if soil can estimate and then again leftover amount you can again add in that soil for artificial soil. This is also for directly you can use for the soil for creating artificial soil. And then type of the design. For larger number of population, we go for the design for the augmented design is better. And they are because I already explained you that CRD and RBD, it is not possible for large number of population. This is just, we are after conducting the augmented design, we come down with the less number of population and less number of sample, then you can go for the RBD or CRD. In field and laboratory condition, I will confirm the in limited germplasm, because in this type of design we can't conduct the large number of population, it is not possible. So physiological work and for doing the screening, that augmented design is most useful. And what are the facility we need? I already explained. Rainout shelter is for drought trace, salinity trace we need, and we need, depend upon the our fund, we can construct the rainout shelter. Then OTC chamber, OTC open term chamber, or in OTC, you can conduct the elevated CO2 and temperature also. You can, within the OTC, we can insert the temperature, fitting the heater, you can conduct the temperature test also. And directly, you can TGT temperature gradient tunnel. We need this type of facility for conducting the temperature trial rate. And phase, free air. CO2 enrichment. By this method, we can conduct the more large number of, not large, but we can more number compared to OTC. In OTC, is less space, so we can conduct limited or limited germplasm we can screen. But here, we can conduct the large number of germplasm by OTC. But here, we have to release the or elevated the CO2 is more and compared to OTC. by the this OT by this interaction effect CO2 and temperature we can study and the identify that right. For salinity trends, and I already explained that the hydroponics we need and that this type of structure we need, and I explained that the Hoogland solution is needed for hydroponics. So this is the mixture major nutrient and micronutrient we can add and for hydroponic for salinity drought you can use. And this for soil salinity experiment, it is for pits we need. Every time we have to change that not every time, it will depend upon our interval, 15 to 20. This is type of structure and we can conduct. The other tools, phenotyping. Phenotyping is the most recent facility for phenomic is in all cameras, all sensors and fitted in the one place. It is also portable, it is the movementable. In that large number of germplasm we can screen by phenomic study for genomic, for understanding gene and the gene expression for metabolic level. But you can buy this way, we can use also the, for breeding purpose also for screening. Here we can screen the very a large number of germplasm also, it is possible. And the only here not manually, only sensor here is. This facility is available at Crida and Delhi also. The measurement of various hepatic traces, physiological parameters and price for drought, pollen, hepatic abscessic jasmonic and relative water content, membrane stability, chlorophyll content, photosynthetic rate, stromatal conductance, water potential we can make. What are the concentration and what is the need for high or low, we can also, you can see here by this table. For drought is also, for drought, water is efficiency, irriga by water efficiency by irriga and isotropic modulatory. Improving the water efficiency by decreasing stromatal conductance and transpiration ratio, maintain the high water potential in the drought resistant. The antioxidant enzymes, we can estimate the anti-major antioxidant enzymes. Leaf area index, plug leaf area. Likewise, the salinity trace, it is the major is the sodium potassium ratio. If it is sodium, high sodium to potassium is useful at rest rate, weaker windage water potential, root shoot ratio, antioxidant, membrane stability, relative water potential, stromatal conductance. High temperature also membrane stability in the stigma resistivity, pollen viability, sterile flow rate, and germination percentage of W, pollen to and grow. Glycine protein, heat stack protein. Here is you can estimate the heat stack protein. Heat stack protein, if it is more, then it is tolerant. Canopy temperature, canopy lower the canopy temperature for higher the yield tolerance. By the instrument, you can estimate. Stay green and delayed senescence, maintain the leaf chlorophyll for longer duration, stay green character. Photosynthetic growth, stromatal character, chlorophyll fluorescence, chlorophyll fluorescence, photochemical efficiency, these are the photo pinching, you can estimate the photo pinching or not. So for high temperature, you can estimate this one. Chlorometer, chlorophyll fluorescence and photochemical efficiency by irriga and photosynthetic rate and this is by irriga. See the very simple figure for salinity or drought or many other traces also. For salinity ionic trace, high accumulation of toxic ions, high osmotic potential. Yet germination, what are parameters we should be take? Seedling dry weight, seedling fresh weight, weight of mobilized reservoir, weight of mobilized seed reservoirs, root length, shoot length, reactive oxygen species, cell membrane stability, electron microscopy, scopy, soil moisture content. But even vegetative, what are the parameters we have to take? I mentioned here. And at a reproductive stage, what are the parameters we can need to take? This is not only for salinity and drought, all the traces we have to take. What are the parameters we can take at a seedling stage, vegetative stage, and reproductive stage? And I already explained that the vegetation is better for screening. For a water logging, a seed, for water logging also, we can, what are the parameters we treat? Here, root parenchyma is the most tolerant parameter, dry parameter. High root parenchyma is useful for stress tolerance. Ethylene or seed tolerance, plant tolerant to low light level. Heavy metal also you can tolerate. Stress assessment and formulas I am given here. In this table, what are the traces and what are the formulas and we have to conduct and we have to for calculation what this stress assessment formulas we can need. As a leaf water content, I already explained that how to conduct the estimate the leaf water content, membrane stability index. Using the measuring the flood drought temperature salinity of water logging, osmotic adjustment, measuring the various osmolarity chemically by using formula. This is the formula. Membrane stability index. I already explained about membrane stability index. And this is the water relative content, leaf water relative content. And if and these are the color chart, leaf color chart. If it is a large number of population is there, and by manually chlorophyll estimation is the difficult, and if you don't have the spad meter also, then can you can use and by screening leaf color chart. By it is not good, but if you don't have facility and the instrument, then you can use this chart. And this is the spad meter. I already explained that by spad meter we can more than large number of population samples we can screen. This is a spectrophotometer by photosynthetic pigments, a carotenoid, we can estimate fully. Among these, the acetone method is very easy. And here is the, we can use the 15 millimeter Polkan test tube. And here acetone, by this, using this Polkan tube, it's very easy, need not to grind. For one day before, you can take the 100 mg as a leaf sample and 80% acetone and keep it into a test tube and close it and keep the overnight, and next day you can take the reading. Here no need to again add the acetone at the time of estimation, and no need to grind because it is a simple for large number of samples we can screen by in this method, but acetone method is better for large number of sample. For flame photometer, we can estimate the sodium potassium, we can by estimating for soil salinity. Leaf area meter, this is the leaf area meter. I already explained that the leaf area meter, if you are knowing the if differently at the type of leaves, you can estimate by leaf area meter. Water leaves efficiency. Water leaves efficiency, you can estimate in three levels. What is crop level? Gravimetry. Less number of samples you can estimate because it is agronomical parameter. Because it is less number of sample we can select. Because here, weight, gravimetry, you can't weight the large number of pot weight, this is a difficult. Then plant level, whole plant level, plant production, biomass, water loss, this is the isotope area, mass spectrography, discriminate study. By this study, we large number of sample we can estimate because there, here we need the grind dry sample. So dry sample we can store and we can do in later stages also, because by this is possible for large number of sample. By this is the leaf level, dirgha, here also we can't estimate the large number of samples. So for water efficiency, it is better and going for the, this method is useful and convenience also. This is the gravimetric method. We estimated, and here we don't have this facility, and then we are gravimetrically we estimated, and then in bursting crop. This is a IRGA instrument. You can use the photosynthetic, photosynthesis, fluoro, rate of photosynthesis. Then canopy temperature, we canopy temperature instrument, you can use the temperature at rest tolerate. If it is a canopy temperature is less, then we get that is a tolerate. Then the isotope ratio mass spectrometry, it is available at US Bangalore. I think you people all you knowing. Elevated atmospheric CO2 enhance the plant water use efficiency. Water use efficiency is the amount of biomass produced per unit of water. See here, stomatal 4, larger opening and small opening. If it is small opening, then it is water loss is there, evapotranspiration is less. If it is pore size is more, then it is the evapotranspiration is more. So if we are selecting by isotope discriminative technique, by this we can identify the pore size of stomata. So C13 and C14. So C13 and 12. So if it is entering C13, it means pore size is more. It is more the water loss. If it is not entering in the stomata, and then it is the small size, you can simply understand it. So this is the waterless water evapotranspiration is less. So it is just all for water is high water efficiency genotype line or lines, you can identify the this technique. It is the most useful. By these are the different osmometers, pressure chamber, thermocycler. These are the we can estimate the osmotic condition of the plant or leaf sample. These are the simple electro instrument we compulsory need for the salinity test. pH and EC meter we need. Otherwise, this meter is not available, and soil salinity and salt instrument conducting, it is not possible. We need also compulsory. Flame photometer already explained. Atomic absorption spectrophotometry, SA. By this way, we can estimate almost all nutrients. Light microscopy. By light microscopy, root parenchyma identification using light microscopy. This is a shade net. Shade, generally, we have available the shade, different gradient of shade. 45%, 75%, 50% and 25%. Shade net is already available in market. You can take, and then by lux meter also you can estimate the what is the shade and what is the effect by shade net. Root study, we already explained this type of structure need for root study. Then after that, removing the structure and taking the root study. And how to measure the root volume and how to color. This is in the soil tensiometer. Soil tensiometer we need because the soil tensiometer, by soil moisture, how much soil moisture is there. By directly you can, otherwise we can, if you don't have instrument or then we gravimetrically we can do it. Otherwise this parameter we need. Then root study mini rhizotron technique, and this is the instrument and software. We can insert the tubes in vertically, and this is the in the slightly bend condition. By this you can root length, you can identify by this way the how much that is the expanding the or spreading the root. By this technique we can identify. This is the camera, the how to image analysis by root length, volume, density, this is a study for semi rootal angle wheat variety for agar gel. See the we can screen the salinity trace also by agar mesh drought trails also, because in agar gel we can for salt trace we can mix the salt, if it is drought is in a PG peg, you can polyethylene glycol, you can mix in that and grow in this by technique, and we can estimate or even, but it is not possible for large number of population, only a less number of population we can scale by truth set. After it is a simple feature for breeding program. Breeders, I think everyone knows how to conduct. So after finding and try, and then this type of procedure you can follow for back crossing, and then progress of fighting tests. See, generally here it is a teosint. Teosint is generally grow and available in soil moisture in South Africa. It teosint is a nature is multi tiller, and root now large number of roots are found in after water logging condition, and Aranchyma is more in teosint. It is a wild type gene maize. Then this is the picture. It is multi tailing. This is the teosint. Then here IGFRI for we have to target and try to for multi tiller and high biomass, not green yield, but high biomass. If it is tiller is more, high foliage is more. If it is there, but fodder quality is, we need for fodder. So and this is the teosint, original teosint, and we crossed with African tall maize for pre-breeding line. This is the pre-breeding, and then we conducted in the confirmatory trial in field condition, and this is the teosint crossed line. It's the multi-tiller and it is more tolerant. We conducted in the natural water logging condition moisture test, and this is the multi-tiller teosint nature is also drought tolerant and water logging tolerant. Maize TO cross were evaluated aligned segregating function in branching and were adverse. So here see the multi-tiller and high branches. So we targeted for multi-tiller and high branching and high. And the cob also it is coming normal cob and normal green. But it is still it is going on under for evaluating. And our Dr. P.K. Ghosh, earlier he was ex-director and DDG crop science, and he was the crop science DDG, ADG, and they are checking that is naturally we crossed or it is multi-tiller or not, he is checking, see the picture. So we targeted that right and evaluating and going on. So this myself work is going on, and again I am working on abiotic stresses, drought, salinity, and we have developed one maize line, and they are in advance. Now we are not really, but going to really drought rallied, and we targeted on drought root length and water efficiency. Then by the and one water by using water efficiency, USA Bangalore, Dr. C.S. Sai and their group, they released abiotic stress breeding, and they released one variety for water efficiency. Thank you all. Thank you for all, Dr. Vinod and IGFRI, Dr. Krishna Nayak and all coordinator, and all given to this opportunity me for delivering this lecture. Why I am emphasizing, because if we are working with the breeder and any other, we are facing the problem, because breeder they will tell that large organism screen it. How it is possible to screen? So I understand, and everyone knows that it is not possible. So for understanding what stage, what how much germplasm we can screen, where do we have to discard, how to move and how to develop the abiotic stress breeding. At present they generally release the variety on a high biomass and high weight, but not on everybody trust building. So if we are targeting and given chance to develop, and if it is came to chance, then we have to compulsory how to follow the everybody trust building for climate change and develop that changing climate condition and develop the variety, and definitely it is just sustainable for in future. So for thank you for all Dr. Vinod for giving the opportunity me madam. I learned most of techniques from Edna madam, RV Koti sir. I trained 3 months at Dharwada in 2014 soil salinity experiment how to conduct, because I completed PhD and joined. Every scientist they are completing MSc and PhD, they have only one parameter or one stress, but not all. So by most of things I learned Dr. Koti. Thank you for all plant physiology from Dharwada USA and giving to chance to me for delivering this lecture. Thank you for all and for audience also.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot for being with us. If there are any questions relating to the topic, please ask now. We can have that Q&A session right now.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, Devanayak sir, it is really very nice session.
Thank you.
I am Dr. Chandranayak speaking.
Okay, sir.
I think a student have no questions, so just I started to share a few things with you.
Okay.
Really, it was a very excellent presentation. I felt so happy.
Sir. Thank you, sir.
Because you covered all the equipments which are very much required to screen the screen for abiotic stress.
I bet it is, sir. Because we are not knowing and we are not, then it is not possible, sir. That's what for I understand first to what to need.
No, this is very much important, especially for students.
Students, sir, important for students.
Whoever want to screen the genotypes and whoever want to do the different instruments.
Instrument
used for what purpose?
Then only.
Very excellent. Actually, it is very badly needed.
Okay.
And what I understand from your presentation is we should have to have one course in MSc like this one course for the different types. Application in master's and PhD degree.
What is the compulsory course?
This should be one course actually.
Right, sir. We are telling right, sir.
No department they have this facility.
If you don't have facility, you can alternate way. That's what I explained, that in the alternate, if you have, you can, if it is phenomic facility is there, in crores of rupees we need. If you don't have that facility, we can go in other way, we have to come out. Otherwise, when I joined here, sir, I don't have that. I studied MSc and PhD from here. I don't have the facility from here. So I understand 6 months taken the time period, what to do. I don't have, I won't get in future also. But what way you have to come out? Because they have facility, they will work. I am not having facility, I can't sit without work, no? So I have to go in other way and I have to work. So that is the, and this type of, and this work is near to for field conducting experiment and farmers also, sir. We are collecting and that is the simple way, and again going farmers, it is busy way, in not directly affect, sir. It is near to farmers field.
Yes, that's what I understood is while preparing a program of research.
What
we do is while adding some of the parameters, we discuss that hey, this instrument is not available, please remove this.
Sir.
You do not know exactly which instrument is available here and what is the exact. So this should be one course, sir. And this should be a course for the students. They can understand well. They themselves, they can plan their work in the
language. In future, sir, definitely we need. At present, what, you know, suppose breeders, they are developing, they are identifying the mechanism. It is one way. In future, is the changing climate. We have to sustainable agriculture production. We definitely we need the FIT test bidding, and we need compulsory.
Okay. So, Dr. Sir, is there any climate resilient maize fodder species?
Climate resilient, sir. Here, most of we can say that fodder species is spineless cactus. Spineless cactus is resilient to climate change. Cactus, you know, no, sir. Cactus here is available. Cactus. A lot of germplasm is there and going on research on, sir, that species. If you want, you can take. And the Harwada people, I think they are senior, they have, sir.
Yeah, yeah. Because one student has sent a message. It's a question. So I just ask you.
Okay. Grasses or crops are resilient, sir, because grasses extend. Because why I explained grasses and crop, we have to extend the crop, grain crop, then suppose 6 EC, soil EC. Yeah. Generally, but most of grasses, they extend the 6 EC, so we can extend them to tolerate more than grain.
Okay, that's up. One submission to you.
Okay, sir.
Please, you send me this information, like what are the instruments, physiology related, and what are the uses, and if you have the protocol. Please make one send us, so that we can implement one course to MSc Agriculture Physiology, and your name will be there.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Yeah. Sure, sir. I will send.
So, students, they have any questions? Please ask if you have any questions. And we are observing your attendance only today. If you see here, only 70 number is present.
Try to
log in higher side, because we have nearly 300 number.
Okay,
and, try to involve in the discussion and try to ask questions.
Okay. And later also we can send by email ID, sir. I will explain. Have any questions, they can send by my email ID.
Okay, Dr. Sir, if no one have no questions, I think it is the time to say what are thanks to you.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you so much. First of all, Dr. I am given a chance to me. I forcefully asked it, sir, because I am patient problem. I am also student one of a time. I came to and I have to explain. I forcefully asked it to sir, this type of lecture is needed, and Vinod sir, they are given to chance me. Nayak sir, all coordinator. Thank you.
Please find some of the students are sending messages in the form of question.
Okay, sir.
You can please answer them later.
Later I will explain. They mail to me. They tell them to mail me. I will reply.
Students, if you have any questions, you can send a mail to sir also. No problem.
Okay.
You can send a message. And if no one have questions, I think I am really very much happy to hear your class. And as a physician, I take the opportunity to thank you on the behalf of the NADCL and behalf of Agriculture University Dharwad and Agriculture University Raichur, and also on the behalf of Department of Crop Physiology. I thank you so much, Dr.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Let's join back tomorrow.